We thank you for the attention and for the privilege to be with you. Have a nice day.
Thank you, Ashanov, for a very interesting presentation. Now I would like to invite Kim Jin-suk from Korean Social Enterprise Promotion Agency.
Xin chào. My name is Jin-suk Kim. I'm very happy to be here for delivering the presentation on Beyond of Russia. I have worked for the decade for the government, including 16 years of experience in Korea Labor European Corporation. In Russia, I'm in charge of consolidation process of social and cooperatives and certification process of social enterprises. In KCOMER, I took part in making several sub-programs for the employees from 1996 to 2002. These programs became the primary model of social job programs in Korea. KOSHIA stands for Korea Social Enterprise Promotion Agency. KOSHIA is established by the law on the promotion of social enterprises. KOSHIA is public corporation for the central government. KOSHIA plays a role as supporting agency and coordinators between the government and civil sector. Main services of KOSHIA are shown in the right side of the slide. The slide I have prepared for today consists of three sections. And the first section is about a brief history of social economic Korea. And the second section, 30 types of social economic organizations. And the third section, the issues and challenges of current policies. I will focus on the second section because of the time limit for presentation today. The development stages of social economy in Korea could be classified in four stages according to remarkable events. The first stage is the agrarian butcher and system stages. And the second stage is the traditional large-scale cooperative stages, and the sub-stages, the new types of social organization stages, and the first stages, the legislation of new type of social economic stages. Remarkable events of each stages are shown at the bottom of the slide, such as the large cooperatives, small businesses for poverty reduction movement, social enterprise by SEPA and cooperatives by FAC. I picked the name of each stage from the remarkable events of each stage. On this slide, remarkable events of each period are summarized. Remarkable events and brief history of Korean social economy will be displayed from slide number 6 to 14. But I will skip explaining about them because of the time limit for presenting today. But please remember this. If you want to understand the Korean social economy, you need to know about this classification and remarkable events of each period. On this slide, the classification of Korean social economy is explained. And on the slide number 6, the mutual existence from centuries ago, such as drag and tumashi, I explained. On the slide number 7, the government led cooperatives, I explained. During the rapid industrialization period, the Korean military government cooperatives to develop specific primary industries such as agriculture, fishery, and tobacco industry, and so on. At the later stages, the civil society began to be the traditionalized cooperatives such as credit unions and consumer cooperatives. From slide number 9 to number 11, the new type of social organizations before legislation of SDPA are explained. About several pilot programs, such as rehabilitation support programs and countermeasure programs against the unemployment. And about just 3 weeks. In 2007, the Social Enterprise Promotion Act was enacted by the Ministry of Labor. This act provided for certification systems for social enterprises. In 2012, the Social Enterprise Promotion Act, the frame of act of cooperatives was enacted by the Ministry of Finance. After the legislation of FAC, various small organizations could start diverse and creative businesses with the proper legal entity. On the slide number 40, the bill is being proposed to the National Assembly, I explained. As I explained before, the Korean social economy could be divided into two large groups, traditional large cooperatives and the type of social economy. And traditional large cooperatives could be divided into two subcategories, government-led large cooperatives and civil society-led cooperatives. And then, new types of social economy into subcategories, social enterprises, and new type of cooperatives by the FAC. I will focus on explaining about the new type of social economy because the traditional life cooperatives have different characteristics compared to the social economy recently discussed in Korea. From now on, I will briefly explain about the new type of social economy one by one. The new type of social economy organizations include social enterprise by SDPA, cooperatives by the FAC, and community enterprises, and self-support company. And there are several differences on new type of social economy, such as ministry, legal ground, years of enforcement, legislative purpose, and target beneficiaries, and financial assistance. Intermediary agencies. The number of each organization are shown at the bottom right of the slide. You can understand the outline of new type social economy and from this slide. The definition of social enterprise by law is shown in the box. The related central government agency is the Ministry of Labor. Social enterprises could be defined as enterprises that pursue social objectives and solve social problems. The certification process of SDE is summarized by the flowchart and below. If any enterprise wants to use the title of SDE by law, they should obtain certification from the Ministry of Labor. Before the final decision, they should undergo deliberation by the Policy Deliberative Council. To be certified as social enterprise by law, they need to meet seven criteria. Number one, they should have the legal form. Number two, they should employ paid workers and conduct business activities. Number three, they should have the social objectives. Number four, they should have a democratic decision-making structure. Number five, they should make profit by business activities. Number six, they should have articles of association and regulation. Number seven, in case of the commercial companies, they should invest more than two-thirds of the profit for the realization of social purposes. The types of social enterprise could be classified in five groups by the primary social objectives. To be certified as job open type, they should provide a job for the vulnerable. In the case of the service provider type, they should provide social services to the vulnerable group. The social service operator should be at least for more than 30% or more. In the case of the mixed type, they should seek two kinds of social objectives at the same time. I mean job operating and social services providing for the vulnerable group. In the case of the community construction type, they should pursue the community-oriented objectives. In other words, they should conduct community business. And because of the diversity of the social problems, sometimes it is difficult to determine in which type they should be classified. In the cases, they could be classified as other social enterprises. There are two types of cooperatives defined in the Act. One is general cooperatives, and the other is social cooperatives. The related central government agency is the primary, is the Ministry of Finance. The social cooperative is a special type of cooperatives, and this could be defined briefly as the social enterprises in the form of cooperatives. They should carry out social business activities for the local residents or the disadvantaged people. There are several differences between general cooperatives and social cooperatives, such as legal personality, establishment process, business activities, loans and mutual aid, distribution of surplus. A big difference is in the process is that general cooperative should report to the local government, but social cooperative should get authorizations from the central government. The types of social cooperatives could be classified into five groups by their main businesses. Social cooperative types are similar to those of social enterprises, except for the public trust business type. To get authorizations and the public trust business type, the cooperative should be engaged in public projects as main business activity. The definition of community business is shown in the box. The related central government agency is the Ministry of Public Administration. The definition of CB is similar to those of the community contribution type social cooperatives and the local business type social enterprises. The community business is focusing on the village-related business, so usually they are designated by the village community. On the contrary to this, a social enterprise or a social cooperative is certified by the individual business unit. The process is shown on this slide. To be selected as community business, they need to have four attributes. Number one, they should seek profits by business activities. Number two, they should try to realize the common benefit of the community. Number three, they must realize the common benefit of the entire community. Number four, they should be established on the basis of the region. Looking at it closely, the basic requirements of CB are similar to those of the community contribution type social enterprises. The definition of self-support company is shown in the box. The related central government agency is the Ministry of Welfare. A self-support company is a social form vocational rehabilitation. They should establish and operated by the responsible benefit and people in the second lowest income bracket. The process is shown on this slide. To be selected as a company, they should meet four conditions. Number one, they should have a business registration certificate by law. Number two, they should be established by the low-income people. Number three, they should offer regular working hours to the members. Number four, they should distribute a certain amount of profit to each member members on one. Looking at closely, the basic requirements of self-support company are similar to those of Jacobo-type social enterprises. The public support systems for social economy involves several ministries and departments of the central government. In the early days, labor cost subsidy was the most important means, but with the great criticism for the short-term effect of direct support, the government support programs are focusing on the indirect assistance such as management, consulting, training, and PR, finance, and marketing. The main issues and challenges might be the dependence on society of socio-economic organizations and the lack of control power on socio-economic policies. To deal with this problem, the government has been trying to reduce the direct subsidies, and most parties of the National Assembly are discussing about legislation on the framework and on social economy. That's all I have prepared for you today.